Hash It Audio presents. Ellis Johnson might be famous. Written and read by Shawn Amos. Be sure to look for your bonus PDF of illustrations by Tracy Nishimura Bishop. Sunset cookies, butterscotch cookie. There's a sunset cookies, butterscotch cookie recipe in Helen Johnson's playlist, also in this PDF.
For Roderick Sykes, who taught me to do what I love and love what I do. Chapter 1. Everyone's a Star. Middle school is not for the weak. I've been in sixth grade for 91 days. The way I see it, I'm already halfway to high school. High school is halfway to college, and college is halfway to a job. I'm almost a grown-up. Sometimes I can barely remember elementary school, or that little kid at the cookie store grand opening. Hollywood Middle School is changing me, but not fast enough. My pranks don't work like they did in elementary school. Pranks are for kids. In middle school, you gotta step up your game. Middle school is about talent. Talent gets attention, and attention makes you famous. It seems like everyone in Hollywood Middle School is on their way to being famous. Just look around this classroom. Over in the second row is Diane Clark, studying her sides. Sides are a few pages from a movie or a TV script. Diane is always reading her sides in Mr. Thomas's history class. She goes on auditions almost every day after school. By the time she was a fifth grader, Diane was already in 5 TV commercials, 2 plays, and 1 TV show. She's definitely going to be famous. Sitting right in front of me is James Vance. He's going to be a famous football player. How can you not be a famous football player with a name like James Vance? All he does is draw football plays on his notebook. James is really good at pretending he's taking class notes. He even looks up every now and then, nodding his head and looking closely at the board. He could be an actor too. What no one does in Mr. Thomas's history class is pay attention. Everyone is doing something else. Mr. Thomas is so in love with his history, he doesn't even notice. Currently, he's writing one more of his timelines with another bunch of really old dates. How does learning about 1540 BC help me now in 1976? We have to learn where we've come from to help us understand where we are headed, Mr. Thomas says as he keeps writing more numbers on the board. His sideburns are plastered to the sides of his head like fuzzy pork chops. I pull my harmonica out of my pocket and set it on my desk. It's a lot more interesting than Mr. Thomas's timeline. The harmonica is the best company you can keep. One day, I'm going to be a famous harmonica player. I know it. I already have my blues name, Howlin' Johnson. Muddy Waters gave it to me when he came into my cookie store. He's the greatest blues singer in the world, so he knows something about blues names. The clock on the wall gives me 2 minutes until the bell rings. Now's the time. This isn't a prank. Technically, it's a rehearsal before my first big performance. I mostly play harmonica in my room, at Alex's house, or in my clubhouse at the cookie store. But it's been 91 days. I gotta get serious. Sometimes, you gotta take a chance. I pick up my harmonica. My left hand holds it like a sandwich, and my right hand cups it like a baseball glove. I do my best to ignore the tingling in my fingers. Alex looks over at me, his eyes widening. He shakes his head. I nod mine. It's time. This class is about to hear what a serious blues riff sounds like. I slowly bring my shaking hands to my mouth, draw a deep breath on the left side of my harmonica, and blow. A fat chord of 3 low notes rolls across the classroom. I take another deep breath so I can quickly follow with a second chord. I want to get that train chugging sound. Out of the corner of my eye, I see a few kids looking at me just as Mr. Thomas whips around. Now I lost my concentration and my breath. My middle school harmonica debut is cut short. Darn it, I totally flubbed it. That didn't sound like a blues riff at all. It sounded like a prank. A lame prank. There's the bell. I grab my backpack off my chair and stand up. What the? My harmonica clatters to the floor. I go blank for a second, then quickly pick it up. There's no way I can afford to break this before my big performance. It looks okay, though. I check the engraving on the top cover plate. Blues Buddy. Big uh-oh. Mr. Thomas is standing over my desk. That's not okay. He yanked my Blues Buddy harmonica from my tingly hands. Alex shakes his head as he hightails it out of class. He whispers, "Told you not to do it, Ellis." Mr. Thomas hands my harmonica to me, but doesn't let go. We're both in this Blues Buddy tug of war. Did you know the harmonica is based on an old Chinese instrument, the Sheng? 1100 BC. The Europeans learned about the Sheng over 2,900 years later and made the first harmonica in 1824. And here you are, Ellis, playing your Blues Buddy harmonica in my history class 152 years later. Isn't history amazing? Yes? My hands are getting sweaty. I'm losing my grip on my harmonica. I suggest you join Miss Francis's music class if you want to perform. And if you don't want to lose this for good. Mr. Thomas frees my harmonica. Have a good Thanksgiving break, Mr. Johnson. Yes, Mr. Thomas. I throw my backpack on my shoulder and get out of class as quickly as I can. Mr. Johnson, nice tone, by the way. I smile before I can help it. Thanks, Mr. Thomas. One day I'm going to be a famous harmonica player, a VIP. I know it. Everyone will know my name. No one in the cafeteria pays any attention to me. I blew it. It sounded more like a harmonica prank than a harmonica riff. And if I was going for a prank, I would have been much better. Something epic like my spitball prank on the last day at Curtis Elementary. Kids are still talking about that one. I guess I am kind of famous for that. But I want to be famous for my playing. You only played one note, Alex says. What did you expect? Alex is my best friend, but sometimes he can be too honest. Besides, it was one chord, not one note, I say. Whatever. You gotta play more notes and chords if you want people to know how good you are. Playing one note isn't taking much of a chance. Chord, not note. Whatever! You gotta play more. You gonna eat your tater tots? I look down at my cafeteria tray. Alex's index finger and thumb are clamped onto the edge of my paper plate. He's slowly reeling in my tater tots. I grab the other end with all of my fingers and reel it back. Hey, Alex protests. You don't have to be rude. And you don't have to take my tater tots without asking. I did ask. You asked and took at the same time. That's the same as not asking at all. Here. I put four tater tots on his tray. That's all you get. Alex pops a tater tot in his mouth, then immediately ejects it. Ugh, it's cold. I pluck one from my plate. Yep, it's cold. Dip it in the ketchup. That's warm. Gross. You spend all your time spacing out instead of eating. I'm thinking. What's the difference? Thinking is searching. Spacing out is getting lost. If you're searching, doesn't that mean you are lost? No. It means you're searching for something. Like my dad. He was searching for lots of things before he found Sunset Cookies. Whatever. I need to get to soccer practice. Are we going to the cookie store after school? I guess. You know, it's okay that my botched harmonica riff didn't get anyone's attention, because I know it will. In just a few days, I'm going to be the most famous harmonica player in the world. Chapter 2, Right Hand Man. You got chocolate on Muddy Waters' face. I hold the album up to Alex. There it is. I point to it, smack in the middle of the light reflected off of his shiny skin. You got chocolate on Muddy Waters' left cheek. Alex takes the album and sits down on a sack of flour. He examines the blemish. It looks like Muddy is crying a chocolate teardrop. Alex tries to wipe his cheek. How do you know this was me? We're surrounded by chocolate chips. It could have been anybody. There are a million ways I know this was Alex. First of all, everyone knows our clubhouse is private. The only people allowed in here are Dad and Herschel. Second, they don't open bags of chocolate chips in here, or flour, or sugar, or anything else. They take them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.